Hi, I'm John Riley here at the Memphis Drum Shop, and I'd like to share a couple of grooves that I included in this book some years ago that was published by Modern Drummer magazine. And the book is a collection of columns I'd written for them. And one of the chapters is called Cross Training. And right now the Olympics are going on, and I've been watching some of the training of some of the Olympians. And it's amazing how many different kinds of calisthenics and weightlifting and all these kinds of things that dancers and swimmers are doing that you wouldn't think are related really to their activity. And there's a similar kind of philosophy with drumming where I'm a jazz drummer, but I practice things that are in different idioms just to strengthen myself in general. And years ago, I heard a recording by a percussionist named Michael Spiro. And this recording was called Bata Ketu. And a number of the grooves on that record inspired me to try and make drum set versions of them. And in this cross training chapter, which is chapter 3 in the Jazz Drummer's Workshop, I'd like to play a couple of grooves that are on page 11 that seem to confuse people when they look at the notation or when they hear the CD. So I'll just show you how I play them, and hopefully that'll clarify it. And even if you never use the groove, I think the process of getting comfortable with it will be beneficial. So this first one is based on what we call the bembe rhythm, which is 12/8 Afro-Cuban rhythm. And if my hi-hat plays quarter notes, then the right hand plays. So that's track number 9. And what's interesting is the way the left hand moves, playing even eighth notes against the triplet groove. So the second one, number 10, is a little, just a little twist on that. In this case, the bell pattern morphs from to 1, 2, 3, 4. I hope that's clear. On this Michael Spiro record, there's some bata drumming going on. And it's also in 12/8. And there's a kind of a hemiola that I hear in there, or a lick that ties everything together, that I try to orchestrate this way. And I'm thinking, and then add the bembe rhythm, the right hand part, which can be on the cymbal. Or it can move between the toms and the cymbal. And one of the most common patterns that I like is. If we add the bass drum, now Now, there's two grooves at the bottom of this page 11 that are mixing some of those even eighth notes within this bembe pattern while the left hand does this other thing. And let me see if I can play those for you. The last one I like to play with the snares on, so the left-hand part is the same, just the orchestration is a little different, or the sound is a little different. So I hope this clarifies the notation and the sound, the way the hands move, the way the groove is supposed to feel. And I encourage you to check these things out. There's some other interesting stuff in that book as well. But cross-training is really healthy, so I hope you'll consider it. And I look forward to hearing how you take these ideas and move them forward. Thanks a lot.